Welcome back to the 17 News at Noon podcast, where we share your news on your schedule.
Working in the spirit of the Golden Empire, this is 17 News at Noon.
Good afternoon, and thanks for joining us for 17 News at Noon. I'm Nicole Gitzke. We begin with the latest on the coronavirus pandemic here in Kern County. Today, public health announced 505 more people were infected with coronavirus. We also have learned another three people have died. 110 people are being treated for the virus in local hospitals, according to the health department, while nearly 12,000 are isolating at home. 455 people have died from the virus since the pandemic began back in March. And as cases rise across the state, including here in Kern County, our hospitals are filling up fast. Governor Gavin Newsom warns he may soon issue stay-at-home orders in an effort to curb the spread to help ease the burden on our healthcare system. Now, the governor's announcement yesterday has communities bracing for the effects of another major lockdown as health officials continue to worry about the devastating impacts of the second coronavirus wave on hospitals throughout California.
The bottom line is if we don't act now, our hospital system will be overwhelmed. If we don't act now, we'll continue to see a death rate climb, more lives lost.
The governor's order divides California into five regions, Kern County falling into the San Joaquin Valley region. In essence, if hospital ICU capacity falls below 15% in any region, then the order would go into effect for that region for 3 weeks. Bars, wineries, personal services, and barbershops would have to close while schools could remain open. Restaurants could offer only under takeout and delivery. Retail businesses could open to only 20% capacity. Operations classified as, quote, critical infrastructure would stay open. So far, every region is above the 15% ICU capacity, but our region is expected to fall below that threshold in a matter of days as we sit just below 20% capacity. In the wake of the announcement, there was some skepticism regarding the potential impact on our economy, including Senator Shannon Grove saying in a statement, the governor's response to the pandemic cannot, quote, be worse than the disease itself. Health officials, however, say it is a necessary measure.
With nearly four times the rate of transmission going on in our state that we had just 6 weeks ago, it's time that we actually limit our movement and really get this transmission down. So that's what this is about.
If that order goes into effect, businesses would have 48 hours to prepare. And President-elect Biden is sharing new details about his plan to bring the spiraling cases of coronavirus numbers back under control, including the request he'll ask of all Americans. Here's NBC's Peter Alexander.
With the most dangerous period of the pandemic still ahead, President-elect Biden on CNN unveiling his plan to appeal to all Americans to make a shared sacrifice to slow the spread of coronavirus.
I'm going to ask the public for 100 days to mask. Just 100 days to mask. Not forever, 100 days.
Biden also revealing he spoke to Dr. Anthony Fauci on Thursday and is keeping him on in a top position to help combat the virus and instill confidence in any vaccine.
And I asked him to be a chief medical advisor for me as well and be part of the COVID team.
Biden saying he'd be happy to get a vaccine on TV to prove its safety, following the lead of three of his predecessors, former Presidents Obama, Bush, and Clinton.
And it's important to communicate to the American people it's safe. It's safe to do this.
Despite President Trump's repeated baseless claims of widespread voter fraud, Biden says he hopes Mr. Trump will attend his inauguration in January for the good of the country.
It's important in the sense that we are able to demonstrate at the end of this chaos that he's created that there is peaceful transfer of power with the competing parties standing there, shaking hands and moving on.
President Trump now signaling support for another major COVID relief package that could help millions of Americans.
I think they're getting very close and I want it to happen.
After a months-long stalemate, lawmakers on Capitol Hill growing increasingly optimistic about a deal, focusing on a bipartisan compromise with a $900 billion price tag. The proposal includes nearly $300 billion for small businesses, $35 billion in aid for hospitals and healthcare workers, and restores an additional $300 in weekly unemployment benefits.
We can do this. Let me say it again. We can do this. And we need to do this.
Not currently included, another round of direct payments to Americans.
Well, Kern Public Health is still stressing the importance of getting tested, even if you don't have any COVID-19 symptoms. Some test sites come with a financial incentive, a $25 Visa gift card. Kern Public Health has made 12,000 of the gift cards available using funding from the CARES Act. You're limited to one gift card per person per day. Now, here's a list of the sites that offer gift cards. Three public libraries in Kern, Lamont, Rosemont, and Wasco, plus the Arvin Public Health Buildings, Kern Valley Hospital, and Good Samaritan Hospital. And the Kern County Latino 19 Task Force is holding free testing sites this week. To see all of the testing sites, just go to kernpublichealth.com and click on the coronavirus tab. There you can put in your address and find testing sites near you. Now to an issue we continue to track closely here at KGET, pedestrian safety. Now, a pedestrian was hospitalized last night after being struck by a car in South Bakersfield. That happened around 7:20 yesterday evening on South 8th Street, just near Bell Terrace. It's unclear if the pedestrian was in the crosswalk. BPD says the person was taken to the hospital with injuries described as moderate to major. BPD says drugs and alcohol do not appear to be factors in this accident. And Bakersfield police need your help in identifying two teens wanted for shooting a man. It happened on the evening of September 14th at the La Mirage Motel on Union Avenue. Police say the suspects made contact with the victim in front of the motel. Following an argument, the first suspect shot the victim. The teens then fled on foot. The first suspect is described as Hispanic, slim built, has black hair, and was last seen wearing a white shirt, black shorts, and has a tattoo on his wrist. The second suspect is also Hispanic, medium build, with black hair, and was last seen wearing a black shirt, black shorts, and red sandals. If you have information, call Bakersfield Police at 327-7111. Now to a popular local diner, now seemingly popular with vandals too. Woolworths on 19th Street was hit by vandals not once, but twice this week. In both cases, one of the original windows of the old building was busted out. Owners Mark and Linda Sheffield say homelessness is a big problem near their store, adding they had an encounter with a man this week.
He was really, you know, had no business being in here. He had wet his pants and various things. But anyway, and we asked him to leave, and he got pretty belligerent about it. So I don't know if he might have come back and done it.
The Bakersfield Police Department is investigating this vandalism. Welcome back. Let's check back in with Kevin now.
Well, Nicole, a nice afternoon ahead with temperatures in the 60s, clear skies, and guess what? No wind. So that's always nice after seeing a breezy day yesterday. Again, 61 degrees on the temperature. We just have that light southerly wind at 3 miles per hour. Yesterday, we hit 74 degrees with that downsloping wind. And today, we're not going to be that warm. As we take a look at the record, 1939, sit back, and we hit 82. No 80s either. And mid-60s out of Sacramento today. 66 in Fresno. 70s, though, down to Los Angeles, San Diego. And if you're headed east into Vegas, 61. The beach is looking great. Today, Pismo Beach, 71 degrees. There's a high surf advisory in place. And the system that brought us a wind yesterday has moved off to the east. Air quality will be moderate for you today. AQI at 73. And here's what we're looking at. Plenty of sunshine and northwest wind 5 to 10. 67 in Bakersfield, 66 in Delano, and Taft at 64. For the mountains in the Kern River Valley, sunny skies. Still that breeze out there, but not as strong as yesterday. Out of the northwest, 10 to 15. 60 in Fraser Park, 58 in Tehachapi, comfortable there, and 60s into the Kern River Valley. Lake Isabel at 67, and then out in the desert, we'll look for sunny skies here in northeast wind 10 to 20 and 61 in Mojave. Here's your extended forecast heading into the weekend. Tomorrow, 66, nice and comfortable under sunny skies. A little bit cooler for Sunday and Monday as we see that system off to the east, and then right back up into the mid-60s next Tuesday and Wednesday. Overnight, still in the 30s and 40s for the mountains, sunny skies throughout the next 7 days. We'll be in the 50s to lower 60s. Overnight, 20s and 30s. And then for the Kern River Valley, tomorrow, 68. A little bit cooler on Sunday, but then early next week, Tuesday, Wednesday, we'll be right near 71. So overall, a very nice weekend ahead for all of us here in Kern County. Have a great weekend. Nicole will have more news right after the break.
And Imagination East Bakersfield is inviting community members to the 2020 Lowrider Toy Run. It's happening Saturday at Beach Park. Registration will begin at 9 a.m. before the cars roll out at 10. The organization is accepting one unwrapped toy or a $20 donation without a toy. All proceeds will go to the Autism Society of Kern County. Event organizers ask attendees to please wear a mask and practice social distancing. And toys continue to fill up on our front lobby here at KGT as our 17 Days of Christmas drive continues. We are teaming up with the Bakersfield Homeless Center and Boys and Girls Club of Kern County to collect toys for disadvantaged kids. You can drop off your unwrapped toy here at our studios or at the Bakersfield Homeless Center or the Boys and Girls Club. We are collecting gifts for children of all ages now through December 17th. And in the giving spirit of the Golden Empire, we are teaming up with Telemundo and local radio stations for our annual Day of Giving to benefit Children's Miracle Network and the Lawrence Small Children's Center in Bakersfield. Now, things will look a little bit different this year. We will host the Day of Giving at our studios. With COVID-19 restrictions in place, it simply wasn't feasible to host our fundraiser from the lobby at Memorial Hospital. Demi Melchok and Jim Scott will join 17 News at sunrise and get it all started, and will continue to host the drive until 7 p.m. You can tune in this Wednesday, or you can donate now by going to miraclemaker.org or texting KGET to 51555.
Working in the spirit of the Golden Empire, this is 17 News at Noon.
The 17 News at Noon podcast is a production of KGET and Nexstar Media Group. For more on all of the headlines in today's show, head to KGET.com.